Let's take a look at how Power BI is infusing AI-driven insights everywhere that people get work done. Let's start in PowerPoint, where my boss Kim and I are working on a monthly business review deck for a hotel and resorts company. We want to help our team dive into the data for who are our customers and what is driving repeat visits to our properties. Kim's left a comment asking me to add the data for a demographics breakdown of our customers. Fortunately, I have a Power BI report with just this data. We all know that copy-pasting data and charts into PowerPoint can be a huge pain, but now, with just a couple of clicks, I can add my report as a live interactive part of my presentations with Power BI integration fully built into PowerPoint. This is amazing for things like monthly business reviews. Now all we have to do is open PowerPoint each month and refresh to see the latest data. I'm going to quickly adjust the look and feel of the report. It works natively with animations, layering with other shapes, and most importantly, in presentation mode. Now, when we're presenting to our team, we can interact with the report and answer questions on the fly. It's a great way to deliver data-driven storytelling and keep meetings interactive. This not only includes just slicing and dicing the data, but in this report we've included Q&A as well, so we can use natural language to get answers. So if an executive or other meeting participant has a question to the presenter, they can answer it in real time. For example, let's say someone asks how many customers we had from Australia and maybe wants to see it broken down by age group and who purchased a spa package. And just like that, we can look up the answer right as part of our presentation. But it doesn't stop there. Let's say I want to include a textual summary of some insights about my data right here in the slide. To help me do this more quickly, we've built in an option to automatically find insights and generate a text narrative about your data. I can simply click the Data Insights option, and Power BI will automatically look at the data in your report page and generate a textual summary of the insights we find. With one click, I can paste the output right into the slide, where I can arrange and edit it as I like. Here we can see the AI is highlighting what countries our customers are coming from, some interesting differences in the rate of returning customers, and an insight about the most common age group. This type of content generation is a huge time saver for building out a presentation. Next, I want to show you another AI feature built into Power BI that we're going to use in this monthly business review, the Key Influencers visual. Key Influencers is going to help us understand the key factors for if our customers return or not. This is an awesome way for my team to see and understand insights we can use to adjust our plans. For example, customers who are booking sports and spa packages are more likely to return, as well as those coming from certain locations. To achieve this, Power BI is automatically building an ML model on the fly behind the scenes, and then ranking the attributes that have the biggest influence on the variable we've picked, such as a returning customer. Further, I can use the visual to automatically see the largest segments of my data to find and share even more insights. And now, finally, I want to show one more new AI capability. To do so, I'm going to switch over and look at the trends for our new and returning customers. Let's click on the anomaly page. While we do have automatic anomaly detection, that's not actually the feature I want to show you. Instead, for this presentation we're creating, which we're showing to my execs, this day-to-day spiky set of data is way too complicated. I'd rather show a rolling average that helps smooth and summarize the data. But I don't currently have a calculation set up to do a rolling average in the dataset. So I'm going to switch over to Power BI Desktop to show you how we've infused Azure OpenAI models to make it super easy to add complex calculations. I'm just going to click on the suggested measure button and type in the calculation I'm looking for, rolling 30-day average of the number of customers. Now by leveraging Azure OpenAI large language models, we can automatically generate the calculation needed to do a rolling 30-day average. I can review the output really quickly and go ahead and add it to my model. Now I can easily drag and drop the measure to add it to my report to get the view I'm looking for to use in my presentation. Creating complex calculations like this can be a challenge for many users, but by leveraging Azure OpenAI, we're making it so that a much wider audience of analysts can get work done more quickly with Copilot-like experiences. I'm going to make a few more changes to my report page to get it ready to share, and now publish it back to Power BI. And now I can use it in my Power BI presentation, or share it directly through Microsoft Teams or SharePoint, or even embed it within a Power app. As you've seen, Power BI is not only seamlessly bringing data and insights into the key experiences where teams get work done, like PowerPoint, but we're also infusing AI to make it incredibly easy to explore data, find insights, and generate content to share with your team.
Power Apps is the best choice to efficiently build modern, high-quality, intelligent applications. Our latest improvements help makers to build apps more efficiently, admins to have more visibility and control, and end users to enjoy more beautiful and modern experiences. I'll show you how our latest innovations help companies like Lumen through the perspective of Taylor, an experienced maker who was recently hired in the company. As Taylor opens the Power Apps Maker portal, they are greeted by this very useful onboarding message. This is because Lumen is using managed environments, providing their admins more visibility and more control with less effort. In this case, the admin has configured an onboarding message with instructions for new makers, but this is just one of the many settings that an admin can control. After reading the message, Taylor notices the simplified navigation in the Power Apps Maker portal that brings the most used options front and center into a cleaner and more efficient experience. If you're thinking, this is great, but what I use more often is not there anymore, you don't need to worry. We got you. First, everything is still available. Second, and even better, the left navigation is configurable, so you can make it your own and have the things that you care the most about always, one click away. In this case, I will add cards to the left navigation because I use them a lot. Taylor's boss, like everyone else, is excited about the experiences and productivity gains that chat-based generative AI technologies bring to users. So they ask Taylor to add chat-based AI to their damage claims application. Taylor could quickly create a new application by telling the Maker Copilot what they need in everyday words. However, the application already exists, so they need to just find it and edit it. And as Taylor edits the application, the first thing that they notice is that the app looks fantastic because it uses the preview of Fluent controls for Canvas. Taylor finds the data analyzer control and adds it to the claims list screen. As soon as the control is added, it can be connected to a data source. Taylor just made the app intelligent in a few seconds without writing any code. So now Taylor runs the app and it looks great. The controls have all the sophisticated interactions and designs from Fluent. And now users can ask questions about the list of claims and get intelligent responses supported by Power Apps and User Copilot. To try this, I'll ask, what is the region with more claims? To which I get an answer from the Copilot. I can ask follow-up questions like, how many of those incidents are urgent? Users of Taylor's app can now enjoy a Copilot that will help them work with their data. And in case that you were wondering, the Fluent improvements are not only for Canvas. We also have a Fluent preview for model apps, which has been modernized using the latest and greatest Fluent components. Coming back to the app, now that Taylor is done with the changes, they are ready to deploy the app into a production environment. With the general availability of pipelines, deploying from one environment to another has never been easier. After the pipeline has been configured in the admin console, all Taylor needs to do is just click a button and their application will be deployed from a development environment to a production environment, like professionals do. We just saw how our latest innovations help improve the experience of makers and users and admins. From helping getting started to supporting advanced makers to create and deploy beautiful AI-infused apps, we have improvements for everyone. And the best, all of these improvements are available for you to try today.
Our Automate desktop now has OpenAI functionalities embedded. From the text with GPT function, there are multiple templates readily available for me to get started across different scenarios. In this example, we are using the text with GPT function to summarize large amount of customer feedback into a paragraph. Firstly, I validate using the test feedback from our customers to ensure that the text with GPT function is able to summarize the feedback accurately. Once I'm happy with that, I would want to ask the user via a display message to approve if the summarized feedback is valid or invalid. Once I've got the information on whether it's approved or not, I make a decision to say if it's approved, I want to include this information in a web-based browser. And if not, I would stop the flow. I now test the flow, first with a scenario where the approval is given, and we can see the web-based form is filled up accurately. And then I retest the function now with a disapproval to not continue with the customer feedback. And you can see the feedback is not approved. I'm now happy with the desktop flow and therefore I save it. Going back to the cloud flow, I can now replace the text with GPT function that is currently there and use purely the desktop flow card to be able to run the whole end-to-end ChatGPT function, including updating the web-based form when the approval of the customer feedback is given. In this case, I'm using the output from the CSV table as an input into the function. Now, how do I monitor my desktop flows? Desktop flows activity, or DFA for short, is a new feature in Power Automate that we've just launched in GA. DFA enables users a cockpit view of the health of all desktop flows and machine that the user has access to. There are multiple pivots available in DFA, and we are currently in the last runs pivot, which shows all desktop flow runs within the last 28 days, including the number of successful and failed runs and trend over time. The errors pivot shows all the errors that have occurred in my desktop flows. I can filter on a specific error type to see which desktop flow it's occurring on and on which machine. This helps me to troubleshoot problematic flows and or machines. The machines pivot, I can see the state of all my machines and machine groups in a glance. This enables me to identify any issues in my automation infrastructure. The current runs pivot shows all desktop flows that are currently running or in queue. Going back to the last run pivot, I want to zoom in on a recent desktop flow run that I've created earlier. I'm now able to cross-launch directly from DFA to the flow run details page, which now shows me all the activities that I've done as part of the desktop flow, including the text with GPT functionality. Thank you.